Charlotte and Burlington, Chapter 1, From America to Europe. Hello, my name is Charlotte. I'm a Sasha doll living in North Lakewood, USA. I'm looked after by Mama Carol, along with my other doll sisters. I have blonde hair, blue eyes, and I love dresses. I have heard grown-ups talking about their amazing travels, and I long to see the world with my own eyes. When Mama Carol asked if I would like to go to Paris, I jumped at the chance. I had always wanted to visit the capital of France, the City of Lights. It sounded so chic. Mama Carol also mentioned she knew a very British bear looking for a companion with whom to discover Paris. What an exciting adventure this would be. At last, my wish had come true. I was chosen to join Burlington Bear. From the very beginning, I knew we were going to be great friends. The journey in itself was quite an adventure. Carefully wrapped up, I took the aeroplane, which was supposed to be a direct flight to Paris. However, things did not quite turn out that way, and my plane was diverted to Brussels. On arrival, I was distressed to find that all my belongings had disappeared. I looked for days, but my suitcases had simply vanished. After a month of searching, unable to solve the mystery, I gave up and I asked to continue my journey. That's how I arrived in Paris.
Nu comme un ver.
Naked as a worm, as the French say. All I had was my teddy bear. Mama Carol had told me to go to the boutique.
L'île aux fées.
Meaning fairy island. When I arrived to meet my French host, the name had made me curious. But in my rush to leave, I had not found the time to ask more questions. What a lovely surprise when I discovered it was a beautiful clothing store for children. It was filled with the most gorgeous smock dresses. Whilst I was waiting to be served, I tried some dresses on. I could just not resist them. There were so many beautiful outfits, and they all looked fit for a princess. Sadly, they were all too big. I had such fun playing amongst the clothes, touching the soft and delicate fabrics. I also tried reading a French book, as Mama Carol had taught me a few words, but I soon gave up. I only had eyes for the dresses. Never had I seen anything quite so pretty.
Mon enfant, où est votre garde-robe?
My child, where are your clothes? Exclaimed the lady as she saw me hiding behind a dress rack, looking a little embarrassed. I told her of my adventures, and when I had finished, I saw her face suddenly light up. She said,
Ma petite, vous aimez voyager, n'est-ce pas?
My little one, do you like to travel? Come to our atelier in Madagascar. It's on this beautiful island that all our dresses are created. A designer who is nicknamed the Queen of Smocks will be delighted to make a whole new wardrobe for you. She then went on to explain that to be a true Parisian and to be seen in the capital, you simply have to have new gowns made. Delighted at the prospect of a new adventure, I was, however, a little concerned about Burlington Bear. What would happen to him if I left for a trip to the other side of the world? Do you think he could join me? I asked with pleading eyes. I do think he may need a new suit to look like a French gentleman. Excellent idea. There are no problems, only solutions to be found, she replied. Nothing is impossible. The word itself says I'm possible. However, we do not have a moment to spare. Time to get you on the next plane. Your friend will join you a little later, straight from England. Safely packed, but still naked, my teddy bear and I made a long 10-hour flight to Madagascar. On the aeroplane, I have time to think and imagine. What would this new adventure be like? The country is nicknamed the Red Island. What will it look like? Will the designer really be able to make smock dresses just for me? In each chapter, we will teach you a little French. To help you learn how to pronounce the words, there are 5 illustrated words which can be listened to in our French vocabulary video. A full French version of this audio is also available. All the links can be found in our video captions.
Merci, bon voyage et bon apprentissage.